Aircraft carriers are the backbone of the American fleet. They sail with a battle group of warships to support them. The biggest displace over 90,000 tons. Each one is like a small town sailing the world's oceans, with a population of between 5 and 6,000 people. No other country comes near them in carriers. The Soviet Union has 5, the biggest just over a third the size of an American nuclear carrier. All this effort and expenditure is dedicated to just one purpose, to be able to deploy aircraft at sea anywhere in the world. Their purpose is clearly to be ready for war. In war or peace, they are a marvel of engineering and of organization.
The flight deck of an aircraft carrier is one of the busiest places in existence, in which every man knows precisely what he is supposed to do, and he does it in harmony with the others. The organization and the discipline is extraordinary. And it's amazing when you recognize the average age of the people on the entire ship was 19.6 years old.
Built as a central part of a superpower navy, America's modern carriers have never fought a naval battle. They've been used to project American power around the world. The most significant deployment was in the Vietnam War. They served as floating airfields off the coast, remote from guerrilla attack, from which airstrikes could be launched.
I had never seen air power from an aircraft carrier used so effectively. I do not think the United States could have prosecuted the war in North Vietnam without aircraft carriers.
Navy pilots in Vietnam did many of the jobs their predecessors did in the Second World War. Attack aircraft bombed the enemy, providing close support for ground troops, while fighter pilots fought battles for control of the skies.